All right, so we're going to talk a little bit about work-life balance. Probably do a couple videos on this because it's a big topic. There's a lot of things that go into it. And there's a lot of things that I've learned over the years from trial and error, from doing it the wrong way and figuring out the right way to do it. So I want to take some time to talk about that because as a business owner, as an entrepreneur, as you grow the things that you're doing, having work-life balance is kind of an interesting thing. So everyone thinks that it has to be equal parts, equal work, equal family, equal fitness, right? And what I've learned over the years is that it's very tough if you put yourself into that confinement of having to have all this stuff equal, you're gonna drive yourself nuts because it's just not possible. What I've kind of learned is that for me, there's seasons of life that we're in. Some seasons that we have, we are all about, it's all about the hustle, it's the work, it's growing a business, it's making money. You know, and sometimes that season of your life, you have to be really dialed in on that. Now, that season of life, for some people, unfortunately, never stops. They're always all in on that, and then they neglect the other things from fitness to family that are super important as well. So the key is recognizing that. And a couple of examples for us, when a season of life for me, before my kids were born, it was work, 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 work. A good friend of mine over the years that I've developed is, that we've developed this friendship is the owner of Carrot, CEO over there, his name's Trevor. You know, him and I were having a conversation. He had his kids before me and we started talking about this work-life balance process. And you know, what it ended up coming down to is as an entrepreneur, as a business owner, you're always gonna have opportunity. And what it came down to kind of balance things out from working all the time was picking the right things to say yes to and saying no more often. So we started looking through a different lens when my kids were born in regards to what does that look like? So we started saying no more often, and that helps provide a little bit of work-life balance for you as well. So that's one thing. Now, also when my son was first born, I'd been out of shape. I was growing up as a kid, I was playing sports, I did a lot of different things. I was always I was that kid who was always working out and when other people were out hanging out. And I got out of shape. I hit college, I did the freshman 20 and all that crap, and I stopped working out and didn't pay attention to my fitness. And then my son was born, and so about 14 years there, I didn't pay any attention to it. And it was, when my son was born, I realized I needed to do something different, all right? I needed to set the example of being healthy, and I also realized that I wanted to be around. So I went through a 90-day period where my season of life was getting back into the best shape of my life. And I went from, during that time, I went from being out of shape to in shape. I dropped 40 pounds in that process. I went down to 6.5% body fat. But once I created that better fitness, I decided, all right, it's time to start, you know, dialing it back. That season was over and the habits were built to continue. So I'm telling you these examples to give you kind of an understanding that our seasons are different. So for example, we moved, another great example is when it was all poured into family was we moved to San Diego for 3 years. We up and picked up, I think it was May. I've been asking Susan, my wife, for a while, like, hey, let's go to San Diego, let's move out here and check it out. She kept saying no, no, and we take a family trip out there. She wasn't interested, and my son, he was 5 at the time. We're sitting at this beautiful view overlooking La Jolla, and my son was like, we should move here at 5. 2 months later, we lived in San Diego. So we actually put everything and packed everything up, moved out. I'm shooting this video from the house that we owned before we moved to San Diego, and we still own it now, we came back. But when we moved to San Diego, I knew that was a time that I had to pour, a season of my life that was pour energy into my family. To kind of wrap and sum this video up a little bit for you is, for me, work-life balance, you have different seasons that you have to be all in on those moments. But at the same time, if you're all in on, let's say it's a time that you're focused on business and you're growing and you're scaling your business, when you do have that family time, you gotta be all in. Shut it off, turn it off, and go focus on the family and make sure that, you know, you're not neglecting them or you're kind of, a lot of people will be doing this. You'll be at the kids' soccer game. Instead of watching, you're sending emails. Right? Or you'll be sitting at a family movie night hanging out, which we do often in my family, and you're checking your messages. So these are things you shouldn't be doing. You should be checked into the moment, and that's way to be all in as opposed to being all focused on everything else, right? So anyways, be all in at that moment will help you have a little bit more balance, because you won't feel as if you wasted your family time focused, half checked out, focusing on the business you're building. You know, there's these things that you have to do, and the key is just recognizing it, and don't get in the trap of always being in one season. Because what's going to happen is, if you're in the one season and you're in grind mode and you're hustling all 24/7 in your business and you're not paying attention to anything else, all those other things are being neglected, and it's going to show up in the long term for you. So just focus, like, understand, like, accept this might be my season, be in, but understand you got to pick your head up and look around and make sure that you don't stay stuck in a season the entire time. So work-life balance, a very tough thing to accomplish, I think, but you know, it's something that people try and strive for. I think they look at it through the wrong lens. And so hopefully this video will help you start looking at it through the right lens. Hey, look, if you gain value from this video, like, comment, share with a friend that's gonna gain value from it. We appreciate it. I'm trying to get our message out to help more people. So do us a favor, like, comment, share.